Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to the next video in Kotlin, and we will get started with the data types. There is nothing fancy in Kotlin. It is the same 8 primary data types that you see in Java are also available here in Kotlin. Digits, numbers without the floating point, it's byte, short, int, and long. Then the decimals are represented using float and double. Characters are using char data type, and the boolean is represented using boolean data type. All these data types have different range in terms of number of bits that they can accommodate. I will not go into those details because you can find about them pretty easily on the official documentation. I will provide you the link for this particular page if you want to read more about the range and the bits that this data can accommodate. Please go ahead and read them. Continuing further, the next obvious question is, how do we declare these variables in our program? In Kotlin, you declare a variable using keyword called as var, and then you write the variable name. And then you have to tell what is the data type of this particular variable name. For that, you will write colon data type. That is, you would write colon byte, short, double, float, anything for that matter. And then you assign a literal. So in reality, what this template would actually look like is where sample value, you declare the data type of it as colon int, and then you assign a literal 10, which is an integer. The main difference between Kotlin and Java is you need not always give data type. You can just drop the colon data type and sample value will automatically take a data type of int. This is called as type inference. This is not unique to Kotlin. A lot of other programming languages like Python, JavaScript, Swift have it. So basically what type inference means is, depending upon the kind of literal that you are assigning to the variable will totally assume that data type. You don't have to explicitly mention the data type. So let's explore this further through some hands-on coding. So here I have created a package called as com.demo.variables, and I have created a file called variable-demos.kt, and I have written a function with main, which you are already familiar with in the previous video. Here, let me now declare a variable. So let me start with variable sample number, and then I can write int and assign a value 10. And if you see here, it gives a suggestion that explicitly given type is redundant here. What IDE is telling me is, you need not write this colon int. I can just drop this and this is still perfectly fine. Now it is giving me a warning that variable sample num is never used. I will use it. So let me print number. I can still write in the old Java fashion and it will print the number. You can see that here. However, in Kotlin, there is even more useful manner, and the way you do it is you use dollar sign, opening and closing flower brackets, and then use the variable name. And this is also perfectly fine. So let's continue further. Now I have declared a variable sample num. If I just write it as 10.0, then what is the data type? Is it float or is it double? So for that, let me create another variable here, num2, and I will create it of type float, and then I will try to assign sample num, and you will see that it gives me a compile time error saying that required float found is double. What it is basically saying is, this sample num is of type double because when you declare a decimal number, by default it is always taken as a double. And here I have declared another variable num2, which is of type float, and I cannot assign a double to that. Well, there is two ways you can fix it. That is, you can declare this 10.0 as a floating point number by putting a f there. So you can see that now the compilation error goes. Or you can typecast this particular double into a float. For typecasting, I can use as float. So once again, you will see that the compilation error goes away. In the same way, I can declare another variable num3, which is of type int, and I can try to assign num2, it will give me a compilation error because num3 is of integer type, and I can once again typecast it as int. And another thing that you should be knowing about how you declare a variable in Kotlin is, whenever you use keyword where, the variable is mutable. What do I mean by that is, let's assume that I have sample num initialized to 10.0, and now if I write sample num is equal to say 12.12, this works perfectly fine. However, there is another important keyword that you should be aware in Kotlin, that is val. That is, when you declare a variable with the val keyword, that particular variable becomes immutable. That is, once you assign a value to that particular variable, it can't be changed. That is, you can see here there is a compilation error that val cannot be reassigned. This is a very important difference that you should be aware when working in Kotlin. Var is mutable, val is immutable. And the only way you can fix this particular problem is make this as var. Let me create another val num3 and assign sample num. And now you can see that this is declared as of type double because sample num is initialized with a double literal. Or what I can do is, num3 is float, it will give a compilation error, and I can do toFloat, that will also solve the problem. So you need not always use as float, you can also use toFloat, but you have to be a little bit careful, because if the number cannot be converted into an appropriate data type, then it will give a exception. For example, I can even write a string here, 12.12, and it still works perfectly fine. There is no compilation error. And if I try to run it, so before running it, let me print the variable. You can see that it successfully converted it into a float. However, if I write anything here, this will basically give a runtime exception. You can see that number format exception is thrown. So be careful when working with toFloat, toInt. And you might be wondering, if sample number is of primitive data type, then how can I invoke a method on primitive data type? So basically what happens is, it basically gets treated as a wrapper data type, and you can invoke a method on the primitive data types just like you would invoke a method on an object. So in this video, we basically covered the concept of variables, how you declare a variable, another way of declaring a variable in Kotlin, that is val, var is mutable and val is immutable, how do you typecast and use these methods like toFloat, toString and toInteger associated with that particular data type to convert that data type into something else. So stay tuned for the next videos. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.